In the name of Allah, the most merciful, all praise is due to Allah, and may Allah peace and the blessings upon the Prophet Muhammad, his family, his companions, and upon all previous prophets, Moses and Jesus and Abraham. We are Muslims. We make no difference among all of them. لا نفرق بين أحد منهم ونحن له مسلمون. Thanks to Allah that Allah makes us all Muslims and characterized our ummah as a moderate and just ummah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله. إذ أخرجه الذين كفروا ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار. إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا. فأنزل الله سكينته عليه وأيده بجنود لم تروها. وجعل كلمة الذين كفروا السفلى وكلمة الله هي العليا. والله عزيز حكيم.
إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله إذ أخرجه الذين كفروا ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا فأنزل الله سكينته عليه وأيده بجنود لم تروها وجعل كلمة الذين كفروا السفلى وكلمة الله هي العليا والله عزيز حكيم.
If you do not aid the prophets, Allah has already aided him when those who disbelieved had driven him out as one of two, when they were in the cave, and he said to his companion, Do not grieve. Indeed, Allah is with us. And Allah sent down His tranquility upon him and supported him with angels you did not see and made the word of those who disbelieved the lowest, while the word of Allah, that is the highest. And Allah is exalted in might and wise.
In that verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if you do not help the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it doesn't matter, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helped him when he migrated, when the disbelievers, when the non-believers drove him out of his beloved city, Mecca, with his companions, Abu Bakr and Siddiq. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helped him when they were in the cave of Hira and protected them. Dear respected viewers, welcome to another episode of your program, Revelations, about the Hijrah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Salamu alayhi alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, إِنَّ عِدَّةَ الشُّهُورِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ إِثْنَى عَشَرَ شَهْرًا فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ يَوْمَ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ مِنْهَا أَرْبَعَةٌ حُرُمٌ. Allah says that in the Holy Quran that the number of the Islamic calendar in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is 12 months. Among of them, there are four sacred months. These four sacred months, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam illustrates and clarified them in the farewell Hajj, Hajjatul Wada', in the hadith in which narrated by al-Bukhari, that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that As-sanatu isna ashrat shahra minha arba'atun hurum thalasun mutawaliyat Dhul-Qa'dah wa Dhul-Hijjah wa Muharram wa Rajab mudar bayna Jamadiyya wa Sha'ban. In the hadith in which narrated in Bukhari that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addressed people in the farewell pilgrimage and saying that the sana or the year, the Islamic calendar in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is 12 months. Among of them, there are four sacred months. Three of these sacred months are consecutive, which is Dhul-Qa'dah month and Dhul-Hijjah month and Al-Muharram. And one of them, which comes separately, which is the month of Rajab, which comes between Jamada and the month of Sha'ban. In that hadith, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam clarified for us that Al-Muharram is one of the four sacred months that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbids and prohibited Muslims to fight. In that month of Al-Muharram, a lot of events and a lot of things, or a lot of special occasions took place during the life of during the era of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. At the beginning, at the first day of Al-Muharram, it was the migration and the hijrah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Mecca to Al-Madinah.
إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله إذ أخرجه الذين كفروا ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا
فأنزل الله سكينته عليه وأيده بجنود لم تروها وجعل كلمة الذين كفروا السفلى وكلمة الله هي العليا والله عزيز حكيم.
If you do not aid the prophets, Allah has already aided him when those who disbelieved had driven him out as one of two, when they were in the cave, and he said to his companion, "Do not grieve, indeed Allah is with us." And Allah sent down his tranquility upon him and supported him with angels you did not see and made the word of those who disbelieved the lowest, while the word of Allah, that is the highest. And Allah is exalted in might and wise.
Still spread Islam in Mecca. The Prophet Muhammad still called people for Islam. He went to Al-Taif and found no places and people did not convince about the message and came back to Mecca, still called people to Islam, to the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to minister them. And Islamic and the followers of Islam increased and rapidly, and the Quraysh frightened from that. That's why their punishment and their mistreatment redoubled and extreme. And even they went to Abu Talib and said that if your nephew wants money, we will make him the richest among us. If he needs a position, we will make him the leader upon our leaders. And then Abu Talib said to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that your people came here and asking me to withdraw my protection, and saying that if you need money or if you need a position. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, though of the extreme punishment and mistreatment, still believe in what he's doing, and still has a commitment, still has a very strong will. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied to Abu Talib, عمه, or his uncle, saying that, والله يا عم لوضع الشمس في يميني والقمر في يساري على أن أترك هذا الأمر أو هذا الدين ما فعلت إلا أن أهلك دونه. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying that and telling his uncle that it's impossible that I will to give up that religion or that message, because it's a divine message. Even if they put the sun in my left hand and if they put the moon in my right hand, I will not never ever give up that message till I spread it all over the world. Then Abu Talib said to him, يا ابن أخي اذهب فكل ما أحببت فوالله لا أسلمك لشيء أبدا.
Submission, faith, and patience, you conveyed the noble message, brought the light through your guidance. Peace be upon you, my beloved, Ya Habibi, Ya Muhammad.
Then Abu Talib said to him, Ya Ibn Akhi, اذهب فكل ما أحببت فوالله لا أسلمك لشيء أبدا. Abu Talib replied when he found that, when he listened to the Prophet Muhammad's commitments and he convinced about his replying and his willingness and his determinations to deliver the oneness and the message of the oneness of Allah, that to deliver the Islam all over the world. Abu Talib said that, I will never ever give up to you. And he provided protection to him till he died. Till he died in, as we just saying, that at the year al-huzni, or at the year of sorrow, or the aam al-huzni, or the year of sadness, at that time, still the leaders of Quraysh practice more pressure upon the Prophet Muhammad, upon his followers, till the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam till the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked his followers to migrate from Mecca to Al-Madinah. Before and after the death of Abu Talib, who provided the protection of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always, or the leaders of the Quraysh, always mistreat him, and always, for example, during the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was providing a prayer, or was performing prayer around the Kaaba, Abu Jahl asked one of his servants and one of his slaves to take the innards of the camel to put it on the back of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam while he prostrated and prayed for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And even though, but because after the death of Abu Talib, they started to make a plot to assassinate the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to kill the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's why they take one a strong man from among every tribe and family to assassinate the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam while he was sleeping.
Allah, send your peace and blessings on the final prophet and his family and companions and those who follow.
Once the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam found Yathrib, which is Al-Madinah, known as Yathrib at the beginning, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded the Sahaba and the followers who are severing from the leaders of Quraysh to start migrate from Mecca to Medina. And even while they are migrating from Mecca to Medina, and when the leader of the Quraysh knew about that and recognized that they're migrating to Medina and they're making a strong country there, and making a flourishing community, Muslims community there, they stopped them from migrating. Abu Salama, for example, which is the husband of Ummu Salama, they accepted Islam at the beginning. And they migrated or start to migrate from Mecca to Medina, but actually while they're migrating, as Ummu Salama was narrating in the authentic hadith of Al-Bukhari, while they're migrating from Mecca to Medina, the leaders of the Quraysh and their family and their clans stopped them and against them, and saying that, well, telling Abu Salama, said that, well, you are free that you can migrate, but our daughter, which your wife, you has no control. That's why they take their wife from him. And even they took Salama from his fathers, and Abu Salama forced to leave Mecca alone, leaving his family, his wife and his son, leaving them in Mecca. And even Suhaib ibn Sinan al-Rumay, while he was trying to migrate from Mecca to Medina, he even suffered a lot. And the leaders of the Quraysh started to try to prevent and to stop him from migrating to Mecca. And Suhaib saying them, what do you need from me? So they said that you came here without money, because Suhaib was a slave at the beginning. And then he make a business, a successful business. I become a successful person, a successful businessman. Suhaib al-Rumay, or Suhaib ibn Sinan al-Rumay, saying that, what if I'm telling you about the property, my property in Mecca, would you leave me? They said that, yes, we would leave you, and you can migrate from Mecca to Medina with nothing. So he told them about, and he gave them all the property, and he gave them everything, and just migrated alone. And when he reached to Medina, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam meet him and saying that Rabih al-Bay'a Suhaib, that what a successful transaction that you had, Suhaib. What a successful transaction that you had, Suhaib. That transaction, which is that you migrate from Mecca to Medina for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even you left everything behind you, even you left your home. That's what the case or the situation of the Sahaba. They left from Mecca to Medina. they left there, they emigrated from Mecca to Medina just to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, looking for a cultivated land where they can worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala away from the punishment, the torture of Quraysh. Even if they left their house, their homes, their family, their property, they left everything, just migrated from Mecca to Medina with nothing. And even though the leaders of the Quraysh was trying to prevent them as much as they can. That was the situation of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam before the migration, and even while they are trying to migrate from Mecca to Medina, they left everything behind them. Even the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even during the life of Abu Talib, or after the life of Abu Talib, or before migration, they tried and they take or they seize each opportunity to mistreat the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, while he was praying around the Kaaba, and Abu Jahl asked one of his slaves to put the innards of the camel above the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam on his back while he is prostrating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the more Islam spread, the more they get frightened, and the more they extreme their punishment and their torture upon the Sahaba and upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Particularly after the death of Abu Talib, who provided the protection to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they started to make a plot to assassinate the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they agreed to take a strong man from each tribe, from each clan, to kill and assassinate the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam while he was sleeping in the bed. The Prophet Muhammad, or the Quran, telling us how they used to tell him that he was a liar and was crazy. They used to describe the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a Sadiq al-Amin, the most trusted person. And later, after he spread the message, and because he made a Muslims community and spreading the message of worshiping Allah and avoid worshiping idol, and the Quran telling us that. وَقَالُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِي نَزَّلَ عَلَيْكَ الذِّكْرُ إِنَّكَ لَمَجْنُونَ. They describe, O you that you're conveying the message of الذِّكْرُ, or conveying the message of Allah, that you are crazy. They start to follow and they chase the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam everywhere. Till as we just said that they agreed to make a plot to kill the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam while he was sleeping. And because he knew about the plot, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him about that. He went to Abu Bakr al-Siddiq and telling him that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us a command to migrate from Mecca to Medina, to go to the Sahaba who are go before the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And before the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam leave from Mecca to Medina, actually, he planned a lot and make a lot of things which we can take a lot of lessons, and we're gonna a little bit later. We're going to describe what are the lessons, or we're going to describe for another episode what are the lessons that we can learn from the hijrah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet Muhammad considered the means and the plan for that, and even asked Ali ibn Abi Talib to sleep in the bed in place of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to deceive the leaders of the Quraysh, so that they can imagine that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam still sleep, because they plot to assassinate him while he coming out from his house to go to pray the Fajr prayer or the dawn prayer. And when they entered the house, they found him, Ali ibn Abi Talib. And the second reason why the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam left Ali ibn Abi Talib there and command him that he has wada'a, he has amanat, he has the people. Even leaders of Quraysh, even people of Quraysh, some or the majority of them, although they rejected the message of Islam, but still trust the Prophet Muhammad, still knew that the Prophet Muhammad is the most trustworthy. That's why they used to put amanat, they used to put things in the house of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as amana. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked Ali ibn Abi Talib to return these things to their owners. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam told Abu Bakr that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us them a command to leave from Mecca to Medina. When the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam was to leave Mecca, he started saying that and giving us a very good lesson for loving the country, for being loyal to our home, saying that wallahi innaki ahabbu biladillahi ilay walaw lam yukhrijuni qawmaki minki ma kharajtu abada. So the Prophet Muhammad addressing Mecca, his homeland where he was born and where he was grow up and where he make a trade with his wife and where he married to Khadija and where he started making the da'wah in with his family and then in public. He loving that home and he loving his country and he was so loyal to country. So he's saying that, oh, he addressing Mecca saying that, oh, you are the most beloved country, you are the most beloved city to me. And I'm just going out of it because your people have driven me out. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam giving us a lesson that here, saying that the loving the homeland and loving our home and being loyal to country is one of the essential part of being a Muslim. Another good lesson from the migration, the hijrah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, trusting in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. While the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companion Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, who migrated with him from Mecca to Medina, while they were in the cave of Hira, and the leaders of the Quraysh traced them and they chased them, and they went to the cave of Hira, and Abu Bakr al-Siddiq get frightened, and he was so frightened because they were very close to them. So Abu Bakr al-Siddiq told the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, oh, the Prophet, he whispered to the Prophet Muhammad saying that لو نظر أحدهم تحت قدميه لرآنا, they are close to us. If one of them looked under his feet, they will see us. So the Prophet Muhammad, because replied confidently with a full trust to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying that ما بالك باثنين الله ثالثهما. So what do you think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what do you think of two that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with them? That's why the Quran described it in a very beautiful expression, saying that إِلَّا تَنْصُرُوهُ فَقَدْ نَصَرَهُ اللَّهُ. All Muslims, all people who are around the followers of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you couldn't protect the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it doesn't matter, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provide protection to his Prophet. And then the verse continued telling that is أَخْرَجَهُ الَّذِينَ كَفْرُ, when the disbeliever or non-believer forced him and drove him out of his beloved country to Mecca, is أَخْرَجَهُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا ثَانِيَ اثْنَيْنِ, while the non-believer forced him and his companions, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, to leave Mecca, ثَانِيَ اثْنَيْنِ إِذْهُمَا فِي الْغَارِ, while they were in cave of Ghar, or while they were in the cave of Hira. And Abu Bakr al-Siddiq was saying to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَوْ نَظَرَ أَحَدُهُمْ تَحْتَ قَدَمَيْهِ لَرَآنَا, and the Quran narrates that saying that إِذْ أَخْرَجَهُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا ثَانِيَ اثْنَيْنِ إِذْ هُمَا فِي الْغَارِ إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لَا تَحْزَنْ لَإِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعْنَا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replied to the message of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq being fear because of fearing of the enemy or the leaders of the Quraysh, because they had a plot to assassinate the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was so frightened and telling the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that if the person or if one of them just looked around him, they will see us. They are so close to us. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam doesn't know exactly what Allah would do at that time, but because he totally trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he telling Abu Bakr and his companions said that Allah was us, inna Allaha ma'ana. At that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the spiders to make his web, and the leaders of the Quraysh, because the feet of the Prophet and his companions ended in that place because they traced them in the sand, until they went to the cave of Hira, and they stopped there and just looked in the cave of the Hira. They found that with the spiders and the web is unbroken. So they told themselves that that cave is not inhabited for thousands of years. That's why they never ever imagined that the Prophet Muhammad and his companions could be there inside that. That's why they left it. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, teach us or taught the ummah a lesson that we would take the means and consider the means, and we would take al-akhdh bil-asbab, as we say in Arabic. And then we totally trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
فقد نصره الله إذ أخرجه الذين كفروا ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا فأنزل الله سكينته عليه وأيده بجنود لم تروها وجعل كلمة الذين كفروا السفلى وكلمة الله هي العليا والله عزيز حكيم.
If you do not aid the prophets, Allah has already aided him when those who disbelieved had driven him out as one of two, when they were in the cave, and he said to his companion, "Do not grieve. Indeed, Allah is with us." And Allah sent down His tranquility upon him and supported him with angels you did not see, and made the word of those who disbelieved the lowest, while the word of Allah, that is the highest. And Allah is exalted in might and wise.
Quraysh just been disappointed of finding the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they went back to Mecca, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to Medina. And the people in Medina, they welcomed the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a very good way, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam start to make a brotherhood among al-Muhajirin and al-Ansar. Al-Muhajirin are the people who are migrated with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Mecca to Medina, and they were Muslims. And the Ansar is the supporter of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who are inhabitants and the residents of Mecca. In a very good example, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam make a brotherhood among them. And a good example of Abdurrahman ibn Auf, that he has a brother that he asked him to share the house and the property and everything was him. But actually, Abdurrahman ibn Auf refused and telling him that, "Dullani ala souq." So he asking them, "Where is the markets where I can sell and buy?" And Abdurrahman ibn Auf, in a very few days, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in a very few days, Abdurrahman ibn Auf become a successful trader, and then he gets married and live in Medina in a very good way. And then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam built a mosque in Medina and was a flourishing Muslim community there. And even though he make a constitution between Muslims and Jews and the Christians there, which was the first constitution in Islam.
أيها المبعوث فينا جئت بالأمر.